Watchman Kwasin learning his lesson. If he sees a building burning, he frickin' repairs it. Adding a fourth Rax while Shine decides to expand the upper left-hand position. Mutalisk again flying in. Those mech marines not really losing much. SCVs being pulled offline yet again to just make sure the supply depot will stay alive. Finally, some marines dying through those mutas. Mutas trying to do some sort of damage, but not really getting to the mineral line. Just that one single bunker, I believe there was a turret also being put at the natural expansion between the SCVs and the minerals. Command center in the minerals, I'm sorry. Mutas trying to fly in from the north side. They are forced to go for the main because of that one single bunker and turret, the natural expansion, picking off some medic marines, but not really doing much in the way of economic damage. Did pick out some supply depots, force some mining, but not really much else. Control towers going down, more Raxes, and a science facility. I believe I also saw a control tower coming up. I think I might have actually mentioned that twice. But Shine getting his third up. He really needs to get that third up because his mutas, they haven't been all too effective. Some lurkers out in the field, I think. Scan should be there ages ago at this point, just going for a mutal lurker attack and to try to go for a two-pronged attack to try to catch Kwasin off guard. A lot of turrets in front of the bunker barracks as well, so mutalists are not even going to be able to get anything done that way, scanning to make sure those mutals are running away. A lot of lurkers coming into position, so Shine's going to try to go for a break at the natural expansion. There is a bunker to defend there. There are enough forces. I think there are turrets close by. One lurker going to just come up the ramp and just going to bury there. Scan going to go off. Kwasin going to start off by taking some of these out. Going to be forced to retreat just because far too many lurkers at that position. He's going to be forced to micro his marines pretty heavily. There is a bunker there at the front to help him defend this. But if Shine goes for a full attack, he might be able to break this anyway. Kwasin really needs to get his number of forces up. He doesn't really just now got a decent number of racks up. Fifth Rax just now up. So he's finally going to be able to build up a decently large size force. Going to finally be able to macro up. Mutalisk again trying to fly in from the back. One single bunker and one single turret are pretty much enough. First science was not coming up. We're going to see who starts reiterating. Mutalisk actually flying for the main. Getting through the turret line. Going to force those medic marines back. Oh man, picking off SCVs, picking off SCVs, picking off even more SCVs, gonna go for everything there. Meanwhile, Kwasin decides to completely ignore this, actually gonna clean up the lurker line, and apparently moving out, gonna try to do some damage, not really defending his main at all. I'm not really sure this is a very good idea. Shine has a bunch of drones that just stopped for a second. That was interesting, milling them towards the upper left hand, but they just stopped. Minic Marines have weapons one upgrades at this point. Kwasin just ignoring those mutalists, going to go for an attack. We're going to see where he goes for the upper left hand position. It is much less fortified from what I saw. Mutalists just being allowed to do pretty much what they want. Kwasin has lost quite a few CVs, so I think just every single Marine he builds now is going to be used to defend against those, but he's going to move out. Some Zerglings going to meet those. Mutas are going to actually fly back to help defend. Hydras are in the field. They just get killed the minute they're funneled up to the upper left hand. There's a creep colony coming down there. Those Hydras were not allowed to morph in any sort of lurkers. Medic Marines and Science Vessel are going to come up. Those Mutas not going to be allowed to pick off the Science Vessel. Science Vessel going to move up. Oh, Medics acting as a blockade for the Marines. Marines are going to continue going for this. One single lurker coming in position. Mutalisk are hovering over them. We're going to see what actually these Marines will see. Kwasin going to have enough micro tick that doesn't have that many force left on the ground. Only a few Marines that are going to very least decimate the drone line, but they are going to get picked off. The science forces should be running to safety while the Marines just desperately huddle themselves up to hope to live for 2 seconds more, and eventually they are going to die once all their beautiful, plentiful energy runs out. Okay, wow. Very, very stubborn medics. I don't want to die. I don't want to die. Okay, I should make fun of that. That's just creepy. Kwasin rebuilding three science vessels, while Shine actually taking his mineral only at the 9 o'clock position. Let's see what else he has tech-wise. Has hive tech up, so he's Defiler manned right there. Scourge out as well. He needs to lower the count of those science vessels. Shine actually not clumping up his mutas, just he knows he's the danger of those science vessels. So he radiates those lurkers, should be saving those irradiates soon enough for Defilers, but no Defilers on the field quite yet. The upper left-hand position, not mining at all except for a little bit of gas. Kwasin actually going for that just to make sure it doesn't come up again. It's much would be much more difficult for him to actually attack the natural expansion. Kwasin should also be thinking of expanding and maybe taking, at the very least, taking mineral only. Might actually be doing that. I see a little blob there. Little purple blot might be a SCV preparing to put down a command center. Lurkers and Mutas and Zerglings actually running out to intercept as Kwasin goes for this mineral only. Going to stop it before it even comes up. Mutas and Zerglings actually going to... Oh! Pincer attack forces coming in from both sides with Firebat's radiance going off. One science vessel does go down. Firebat dies as well. But that definitely gave Kwasin more than enough time to completely clean up this mineral only. And Shine going to be forced to run back tail between his legs to the upper left-hand position. I'm not quite sure if he's managing to get enough mining going there as well. Huasen just going to run up towards that position. Science also's first, spotting everything out, going to radiate. The Lurkers let him die slowly. And just going to move towards that, going to move back a little bit, kill those Scourge that are threatening the Science Vessels and the Zerglings. Lurker dies. Medic Queen's going to be able to run up the ramp safely now. Still almost no mining, just two drones, but just taking out that hatchet would be a pretty good idea. Medic Marine's actually going to move right down. There's a meeting some Lurkers trying to stop him, but never mind. Two Marines sitting at the front. We're the scouts, man. We're going to start by doing some damage, and then you guys can come up and finish up. Sunken Colony goes down, and this hatchery, no chance. Wow, look at that health just go down. Upper left-hand position lost. Shine in a horrible position. He didn't even manage to get this base going at any point, really. Huasen, despite actually perfect decision by him to go for that counterattack, allowing the Mutalisks to raise his main a little bit because he knew they would eventually have to pull back if he went for the counter. Rather playing defensively, Huasen went, you know what? Playing defensively is not going to help. I played defensively in the last game against Quanro. Playing defensively for way too long did not help me. So he's learned his lesson. He also learned his lesson in that he's going to stick to SK Terran, really showing his SK Terran skills. Really nice to see Huasen and Light in Group A and B showing off their SK Terran skills. Lurkers and Jafar are going to go for a break with the one Dark Swarm, but there are defensive matrixes on those Firebats. Oh, Marines die to Lurkers like crazy. Firebats survive long enough to at least kill some of the Lurkers. We're going to see will they actually survive to kill the last Lurker. Wow! Oh, man, once a Lurker man just survived under the Dark Swarm Firebat with defensive matrix doing plenty of damage, killing one more Marine that was actually running around under the Dark Swarm, but it gets irradiated. Shine trying to go for one desperate last attack, but he just does not have enough 1-2 upgrades for those Medic Marines. They're just going to be able to rip through everything. Only Carapace 1 upgrades for the Zerg forces. And just everything's going to get completely ripped through another Radiate. Shine going to try to expand the lower left hand, but he's just so behind economically. Huasen has taken his mineral only at this point, just showing how long they can stay up two bases. Oh, Huasen, what are you doing? God, losing every single one of his Firebats due to one single Lurker that he just managed to somehow forget about. Okay, dude, yes, you're winning. In fact, you're winning pretty damn well. See, that's showing that. You're winning pretty damn well. But don't get complacent. You get complacent, and that's how you end up losing. You never want to get up complacent. Sometimes I see players just getting a huge lead and then kind of relaxing a little bit. Oh, I got a huge lead. I can just ride this and win. But then somehow again end up horribly attacked. But Huasen still, despite losing a few Firebats, not really going to be bad for him. Getting engaged yet more forces. Scourge aren't going to be able to... Oh, when way too many Scourge wasted on only one single Science Vessel. Irradiating the Defile. Defile did get up that Dark Swarm, but not good enough. Okay, no defensive matrix on the Firebat to make sure those can get killed. Huasen spotting the lower left hand as soon as that happened. Shine decides to GG, so Huasen gets through. The Red Sniper shows that he is called the Red Sniper for a reason. So Shine, despite some good play overall, did manage to not manage to get through this game. A lot of Fangirls happy that Huasen managed to get through to the next round. I'm actually pretty happy. I always like to see a player that I like, specifically for the TVZ skills, if they get Zerg opponents in round of 16, round of 8, any round. In fact, I am going to be one happy frickin' camper. There are certain players I love watching, specifically for TVZs, Huasen, Light, Lita, Fantasy, but I also love watching him in any matchup. But, you know, they're just some of those Terran players that I really like. So, overall, just awesome, guys. Group B done now. So, Quanro 2-0-ing, and Huasen, despite that one loss to Quanro, does manage to get out 2-1. Just showing that he should just stick to his good old M&Ms. So, let's see. Group E next, Stork's group. I think that's what people are going to be calling it. That's what Nuke's going to be calling it, that's for sure. So that's going to be next on my blip on the radar. GG guys, wrenching out. Thanks for listening. Hope you enjoyed.